What's going on, you guys? It is the Talking Sasquatch. It's great to have you back. A little while ago, I made a video showing off my X-Tool S1 laser engraver, and I've gotten a bunch of questions about it. One question just kept coming up, though. Everybody wanted to know exactly how I managed to pull out the dual-sided laser engravings. Specifically, like this one of Sailor Moon, how I managed to do a custom shape and laser on both sides. Now, it's not super complicated, but it's not something that the software does automatically, as some people were assuming. However, that doesn't mean it's not easy to do, and actually learning the process of doing something like this makes you a lot better at figuring out how to do things on machines like this. Like, that's one of the things that I really honestly wasn't expecting when I got a laser cutter, was that I would start looking at things in different perspectives, learning how to use that laser cutter. And that's what I've been doing with the laser engraver, is every day I'm thinking of more and more things to make with it, because at the end of the day, I just love making stuff. So today I'm going to share some of that knowledge with you, and I'm going to teach you exactly how to make custom dual-sided laser engraved and cut objects. We're going to be using X-Tool's Creative Space tool, which is actually really easy to work with and has all the presets and stuff that make working with this laser even easier. So yeah, let's have some fun and laser some stuff. Let's go. All right, so first thing we're gonna do is come up with a design. Now, this can be literally anything. You can even use AI to generate a design directly in the X-Tool Creative Suite, which is pretty cool. If you wanna see more about that, check out the first video I did on the S1. But yeah, if you wanna do easy something, find something that's just black and white, makes it a little bit easier to figure out shading and stuff, or be a little bit more ambitious, like what we're doing today. Now, I've noticed that most people kind of sleep on doing shading, but guess what? You can do it. Now, this is just kind of a simple leatherette patch I made, and actually came out really, really good. I had to do a few iterations to figure out the shading, but I mean, this thing came out super cool. I liked it so much that I put some Velcro on the back of it, and now it's on the case for my Cobra Instruments Echelon lockpick set. Very cool. So for me, I like using Photoshop to generate my own images and stuff. You don't have to use Photoshop. You can use something like GIMP or something free, but for me, Photoshop, I know how to use it and I have a license for it, so I might as well. So let's hop onto the desktop and I'll kind of show you how this works. All right, so here we have our image right there. This is exactly what the image that's on that leather patch looked like before I actually engraved it. So you can see how the shading works and how, again, I kind of messed around with it a lot. And yeah, this is actually in color. No, it's not printing in color. It's just that the shading works on this really well. So I kind of kept it all as is. So first things first, unfortunately, we're gonna have to lose the text because we can't mirror the text. So go ahead and hide that layer so the text is gone. Now our next step is gonna be to use the pencil tool to make some registration lines. Let's zoom in nice and big here and scroll up to the corners and let's make some 90 degree angles. So we're just gonna click, hold shift, go up, then click, hold shift, go over. Perfect, so now we have a nice little 90 degree, I'm calling it registration lines. Zoom back out, and then what we're gonna do is we're actually going to copy this. So we'll copy the layer. Where's my layer? Layer is right here. Copy this, drag it down to new layer. And then all we have to do is go edit, transform, and go over to flip horizontal. Bam. Ah, crap. See, notice what it did right there. It flipped it on itself. So it makes this little, I don't know, staple looking thing. We're gonna control Z to undo that. But all we have to do is if we control A, so that's gonna select everything, and then go to edit, transform, flip horizontal, bam, look at that. Deselect and we're good to go. So here's our image, it's that simple. So I'm just gonna export this, go to file, export, and let's go to, well, export is PNG, who cares? And then yeah, right here, and double-sided Squatch logo, I was testing this earlier, but we'll replace that with our brand new image. All right, so as I said before, we're gonna open up X-Tools. Nope, that's Xbox. X-Tool Creative Space. We're gonna go to new. So click right here for new one. Click on the image button right over here. And we're gonna bring in our logo. We're gonna always scale it to fit the canvas because this thing is actually a very large logo that I made earlier for t-shirts and stuff. So it's really high resolution. Let's shrink this down a bunch because we don't need it to be this big. Here we go. Sure, why not? And then we can zoom in on it holding control and using the mouse wheel. All right, right about there. So actually the way I'm gonna do this is I'm gonna make a copy of this. So click on it, control C, control V. There we go. And we're just gonna line them up. Just use the arrow keys. And then I can actually click on the layers over here. I can hide our layers. I can see I'm very close. There we go. So as soon as you can hide a layer and you don't see any difference in the image, you know you have them perfectly aligned. I want to delete the face on one layer and I want to delete the registration marks on the other. So what I'm going to do is just click on edit, and then we have an eraser over here. So we can just delete that, and click save. Boom. And yeah, for some reason it keeps moving stuff. I don't know why. Let's see what happens if I go on this one. And then let's go to edit, suit the same way as last time. Let's make a really big, let's go bigger, big eraser. We're gonna delete everything here. Let's see what this does. Delete, so this one's only gonna have the registration marks. Okay, save, boom, cool. And that didn't move things, but this isn't gonna matter because as long as this is within, oh yeah, we're locked, derp. As long as this is within our registration lines, this is all gonna work perfectly fine. So copy that right there. Good, good, good. So now what we wanna do is we're gonna go ahead and click on the registration lines because it wants to engrave these. I don't want to engrave these, I wanna cut them. So what we'll have to do is click on trace and then just let it auto trace and click save. Now I can select cut. Boom. So now it's gonna cut through my material. Now I haven't set my material yet, user defined material. So I'm gonna click on this. We're gonna be using 3mm basswood for this project. So we'll click on that and click confirm. The other thing we're gonna do is I want to outline and cut this out, right? So we're gonna click on the image here and then we're gonna go to outline. Outline's gonna be 2mm outline for it. Perfect. And we don't need an inner outline for this. It's not gonna matter for this thing anyway. Okay, we're almost out of the registration marks, so let's move this down just a little bit. Whoops, Control Z. Whoops, I should move this lower before I do that. Hold on a second. Go back, then go back to outline, go to confirm. All right, cool. Now we're inside our registration lines. Now we're pretty much ready to go. This is a vector. We're gonna set this to cut as well. We're not gonna do this until when we flip it, because remember, we wanna flip this and then cut it. So I'm just gonna hide it. That should make this whole thing work. So now what I'm gonna do, we're gonna hop down to the laser. We're gonna set up our piece of wood. We're going to set our laser distance and our framing. So let's hop on down to the laser real quick and do that. Okay, so first thing we're gonna do is go ahead and grab our wood, place that right over here. And actually, let me rotate like that. I don't wanna waste wood, so I'm gonna print it kind of down there towards the bottom. So we're gonna pull our laser over. Yeah, just kind of slides over. Puts our little X right there. So let me go ahead and press the depth button. It's gonna figure out exactly how low this thing is. Okay, so we're back in our tool here. Let's zoom out. This little X right here, that's where our laser is currently. So we wanna go ahead and set the distance. It's gonna click auto measure, and you'll see the laser's gonna kick in and auto measure. Once it does that, we're gonna go ahead and do framing. Cool, and it's done. So now that we have our depth set, we're gonna go ahead and do mark processing area. That's gonna let us select a rectangle that we're gonna wanna, you know, use as our processing area, so we know exactly how big we're going. So we'll go ahead and hit rectangle, start marking, and we'll hop back down to the laser and start marking our area. All right, cool. So how this works is, and I'll scooch over a little bit so you can see my button right there. I'm gonna set the bottom corner that I wanna start at, which is gonna be right about here, sure. We're gonna press this button. That's gonna load one point. And then let's go to about here. That's about as big as I want it to be. We'll press the other button one more time. Boop. Now we have our framing set. All right, cool. So now that we have our little rectangle set there, we can end marking and click done. Now we see down here exactly where we're gonna be printing. So let's move both of these images into our framing area. Whoops, that was Control A. There we go. Let's Control A everything and then size it all down to fit in here. Brilliant. So that should have everything inside of there. And all we gotta do is go to process. And actually, let's zoom in so everything looks good. Everything looks good to me. We're gonna go to process and see what it looks like. So yeah, it still wants to cut the outline out, which will cut the entire piece out. We don't want that yet. We want it to cut later. So let's go ahead and just remove the outline. So hit back. We're just gonna go ahead and delete this vector so we can recreate that really easily. And then click go to process again. Brilliant. So now it's just gonna do my laser engraving for this guy and it's gonna cut for these guys. Go ahead and press the start button. High power, low speed have been set for processing area. That's no problem. We're gonna click okay. Now all we have to do is go down to the printer. We'll close the lid. Ah, crap. Let me close the lid first. Okay, lid's closed. Click confirm, process again, start. Okay, process. Good, good. Let's hop down to the laser and get it going. Okay, so I'll have you know I did install the vent. So now we are actually properly venting. And all I gotta do now is press the button. Boom. And we should start lasering. So now that that's done, we can open this thing up, move our laser out of the way, blow off some of the excess smoke, take this guy, flip it around. Place this back down. So now we have, let's move it over as far as we can so we can see a little bit better. Now we have our registration line. So all we have to do is bring our laser and line that up perfectly on those registration lines, which is nice because the red part kind of disappears when you do that. So now we have it perfectly lined up exactly where it was before. Now let's hop back into the software and we'll get finished with this guy. Don't forget to close the door. Okay, so now that that's done, we can zoom out and we want to find our laser. Laser's right over here. Okay, drag this over. So all we have to do is take all of this stuff and we're gonna go ahead and mirror it horizontally. Oh, notice the registration marks didn't move at all. So this is gonna be exactly perfectly lined up. From there, all we have to do is take our registration line and line it up exactly with the laser. Zoom in. I think that's gonna be pretty much perfect. Zoom back out, and then we should be pretty much good to go. We don't need the old box because that's not where we're working anymore. So we can go to mark processing area and delete marked area. So now all we have to do is, actually we can delete these because we don't need these anymore. I forgot that we traced those lines and never deleted the actual image of the line. So we have to delete both. Now all I wanna do from here is go to outline. We're gonna give it a 2 millimeter outline, confirm. So that's gonna give me a nice outline. It's gonna cut out our thing for it. So we're gonna go to cut right there. So that's gonna cut all through it. So with any luck, this should all work. We're gonna go to processing one more time. Click start one more time once it pops up. Start, click okay. And yeah, just gonna go down, click the button again, and this should hopefully make everything work. I'm excited. Okay, we'll go ahead and press the button again and get going. Take a look how we did. Open this up, move the laser out of the way. Cut out nicely. All right, moment of truth. Dun, 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 dun. It's perfect. Dual-sided custom cutout. Even has some grayscale on there. Man, this thing is super freaking cool. I love it. It came out completely perfect. Oh man, it's almost like got 3D vibe to it because it's actually etched in there, but it is pretty flat. That's so cool. And there we have it. Custom cut, dual side printing. It couldn't have been easier. Now again, this was printed on my X-Tool S1, but it works the same on pretty much all of their laser cutters, especially if you're using the X-Tool software. Man, this thing's just too cool. I couldn't be happier. And it's easy enough just to add a little keychain loop on top, something like that. Super simple. If you're interested in getting any of the laser cutters that X-Tool offers, please follow one of the affiliate links down below. Or use code Sasquatch, that's S-A-S-Q-U-A-C-H, on any order over $999 and save 80 bucks. I'm just having so much fun playing with lasers. I really never thought I would really be that interested in them, but the more I use mine, the more things I find to do with it. All right, you guys are absolute legends. Thank you so much for watching. Please make sure to like, comment, subscribe, turn on notifications. We'll catch you next time. We'll be right back.